وأنزلنا من المعصرات ماء ثجاجا لنخرج به حبا ونباتا وجنات ألفافا. And we sent down from mu'sirat. Mu'sirat, those that squeeze. Mu'sirat are those that squeeze, meaning clouds push against each other, squeeze one another, and from it the juice comes, the water. And then thajjaj means actually kathratul ma, or kathratul isaba, meaning heavy pouring rain comes down when clouds fight against one another, and you hear the thunderous sounds of clouds squeezing against each other. That's mu'sirat. And from it, Allah says, we sent down water that pours and pours and pours down. لِنُخْرِجَ بِهِ حَبًّا وَنَبَاتًا, by means of which we bring out all kinds of seeds turning into crop, and all kinds of produce, grass, weeds, trees, bushes, all kinds of produce comes, the earth turns colorful because of the rain that comes on the earth. And then he adds, وَجَنَّاتٍ أَلْفَافًا, and gardens that are folded up into each other. Lafif, laf in Arabic, is when something is muddled into something else. Meaning, you know, trees together, you can't tell if that branch belongs to this tree or that one because they're intertwined. That's Jannatin al-Fafa, lush green gardens. Now let me tell you the significance of this passage. In this passage, basically what's happening is, to put it simply, here's the Sunday school version, it rained and the earth came to life. Basically, right? It rained and the earth came to life. In other words, the sky and the earth worked together and out came new life. Isn't that the case? If you look at the passage I just described to you, it started with the earth and it ended with the sky. You remember that? The earth is a cradle, and a cradle is meant to be carrying a baby. It's a mihad, so it should carry a baby. And by the end, Allah mentioned, the sky is very intense. And now that same sky, from it, what's coming? Water. And where is that water going? On the earth. And together they work, and what happens? New life happens. Allah is telling us that when things are in pairs, new life happens. When things are in pairs, new life happens. The sky and the earth are paired, and they produce new life. Man and woman are in pairs, and they produce new life. Guess what? This entire life was compared to one day. You remember that? This entire life is like one day. And it is paired with another day. What is it married to? What's this one day married to? The day of judgment. And when these two get married, then there's a new life. Either Jahannam or Jannah. That's the point, so beautifully illustrated with the imagery of rain and the life coming forth. Allah didn't just make things in pairs, He made things in pairs for a larger purpose. Up until now in this passage, everything we've learned is about one day, isn't it? But this one day should be married to what? The day of judgment. So look at the next ayat. إِنَّ يَوْمَ الْفَصْلِ كَانَ مِيقَاتًا. The day of separation is an appointed time. Now that Allah is done talking about the first day, He's going to talk about the day that it's paired with, because Allah made everything in pairs. You know, it's important, I remind you again, when we come before Allah on Judgment Day, we will testify that on this earth we lived for a day, maybe part of a day. And that itself, the time when we meet Allah, is also called a day. So here's this day and here's this day. They come together. That's when a larger purpose is produced.